Hello, this is Steve from Unexplored Films, and I've got a new tutorial video for you.
This is an effect I tried recently. It's how to blend together a drone shot of an exterior of a building with a gimbal shot of the interior of a building. So this is a great way to showcase dramatically a real estate project or some kind of walk around tour of a building, or even it could work for a short film, any kind of passion project as well, if you're feeling like you want a challenge. Now, of course, you could do this for real if you had a big open area to fly into, but we wanted to try something where you would actually morph through a window, a bit like you'd see in a film for a dramatic, stylish shot. So essentially, we're doing a sort of Birdman thing where you're blending two shots into one, but you don't want anyone to sort of spot the join. This was the test that we shot recently. It's still got a couple of rough edges, but as a proof of concept, we thought it wasn't too bad. As you can see, you fly in through the window, and then the camera move continues via the gimbal. So, how do you even go about trying this effect? Well, the first thing we did was we got the drone shot. Now, as I'm sure anyone who's done a lot of drone stuff will know, it's easier to start with your close end and then move your drone away, rather than trying to come all the way in from far and wide to some really specific point and line it up perfectly in the center of your camera. So that's what we did. We started here. In fact, there's the reflection you can see of the drone. And then we just backed the drone away as far as we thought would make for a good shot. So the first thing we did was we had to reverse our footage of that. That's using time remap in After Effects. We also cheated a little bit because we actually added a slow zoom so that it looks like we're getting closer to the window than we actually did. Because drones are quite wide, we wanted to get a little closer to the window. So that was the first part. The second part was to film the rest of the shot inside. So we just got as close as we could to the window with a nice wide lens. I think we were on a 16-35 on the 16 end with a handheld gimbal. And then we just carried on doing the move. So how do you glue them together? To increase our zoom further, we actually started using a still. We just saved a freeze frame from the furthest our drone could get with our zoom applied because we wanted it to be steady. We wanted it to be lining up perfectly on the window. We didn't want to have the wobble of the drone flying around affecting the shot. So from here onwards, we're actually onto a still. And as we get closer and closer, we just remove what's behind the window. So having a window with some good sort of color contrast is actually quite handy. We had a dark reflection behind and we had a light window frame. So there are several layers going on here. We have a layer at the back, which is having the opacity turned further and further down, so it gets more and more transparent. On top of that, we have a window frame, which stays as it is with the color key. And then finally, we had the brickwork as another layer, because obviously we didn't want that to disappear either. And we even remembered to keep the house plants there on the windowsill as part of the area that doesn't change. So as you get closer and closer and closer, everything stays the same except what's through the window. The next thing we had to do was to pick up with our interior image. Now again, we had the same issue here. We couldn't get any further back than this, so we had to sort of create more of the living room than what you would actually be able to see. So we took a freeze frame of that and we combined it with several freeze frames pointing in different directions. So this was our version of trying to create a kind of fisheye effect to see the edges, but without crucially affecting the middle image, because that's what you're going to have to cut to next. So this is what we did, just in case you're seeing bits of the floor or the ceiling or the walls, just in that moment where you're coming through the window. So here you're actually going from a still image to revealing a still image. So you zoom in, you zoom in, you zoom in to 100%, and now we've changed. Now we're back to the footage. So you've gone from footage of the outside to a still to another still, and then back to footage finally, and you continue your move. And you're parenting all of these layers together to a null object or just to one of the layers, however you want to do it, so that they're all not wobbling around, they're all sticking together. And again, motion blur helps with this. Like I've said in my other videos, motion blur is your friend. It really does help hide a load of messy edges. And there you have it. That was how we did our drone shot to gimbal shot blend. So I hope that's helpful. Give it a go. Tell me what you think in the comments. You can like, share, and subscribe if you enjoyed this, and I'll make some more tutorials. I've been Steve from Unexplored Films. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.